Hey Pixels! This week's video is a part of a very special two-part series on how I coded my one-page portfolio with HTML and CSS. In this week's video, I'll be focusing on the HTML part of the one-page website. Next week, I'll show you how I made it all pretty with CSS. Be sure to go to my website, exopixel.com, where you'll find the original code for this tutorial. Now, let's get started. Open up your favorite code editor. In this tutorial, I'll be using Dreamweaver CC for a change instead of my usual code editor, brackets. Not sure which code editor to use? Read my blog post on the best code editors for web designers. So if you've watched my recent tutorial on how I designed the website mockup for my one-page portfolio in Photoshop, you'll know that I already know how I want my website to look. The website mockup that I designed in Photoshop served as a visual guide that will help me when I'm coding my website. By designing a website mockup in Photoshop before touching any code, I now have all the information I need when I'm coding my website. I know the fonts, colors, images, and layout that I want for my website. Coding the HTML and CSS is going to be super easy now. It's in good practice to mock up a website before touching any code. You'll save a lot of time in the long run. Now, let's start coding the one-page portfolio. First, we're going to code the header by using the header tag. Within the header tag, I'm going to create a div using the div tag and give it the class intro. Within the intro div, I'm going to use the h1 tag and write my full name. Then, I'll use the h2 tag and write my professional headline. Now that we've coded the header section, let's code the about section. I'm going to make a div and give the div a class called wrapper. The wrapper acts as a container that holds all of the additional content that we'll be adding to our website. I'm going to use the section tag and give it a class called about. Then I'm going to create a div called about content. This is where all the text for the about section will be. I'm going to use the h3 tag for the heading and the p tag for the paragraph text. For now, I'm going to use lorem ipsum placeholder text. I'll write the actual content later on. That's it for the about section. Let's move on to the work section. So the third section in my one-page portfolio is the work section. First, we're going to use the h3 tag and introduce the work section by writing a heading. Secondly, we're going to use the section tag and give it a class called work. Within the work section tag, we're going to create a div and give it a class called imageAreaLeft. This div has two classes. ImageArea is one class that we'll be selecting when styling our CSS, and Left is another class that we'll be adding styles to in our CSS. Within that div, we're going to add an image. This is where I'll be putting the images of my work. Now, we're going to create the content part where the information relating to the project will be. Let's create another div and give it the class TextBox. Within this div, we're going to add another div and give it the class TextBoxContent. Within this div, let's add a heading using the h3 tag and title the project. Then we're going to use the paragraph tag and write a blurb about the project. Lastly, we're going to make a button that links to the project by using the anchor tag. Make sure that all of your opening tags have their closing tags. Looking back at the website mockup, there's more than one work item. Also note that the image alternates between the left and right-hand sides. If you recall earlier, we created a div with a class called imageAreaLeft. To create the work sections where the image floats to the right, all you need to do is change the word left to right. So easy. So now I'm just going to go ahead and copy the first work section that we created and paste it below. Then I'm going to change imageAreaLeft to imageAreaRight. I'll do this a couple more times so that in total I'll have 5 different work items. So we're done the work section. Now we can move on to the third last part of our one-page portfolio, which is the contact section. The context section is very simple to code. First, we're going to use the section tag and give it the class contact. Then we're going to create a div and give it the class contact content. Within this div, we're going to use the h4 tag and write a small contact blurb with a link of an email address. I want my email address to automatically open the visitor's mail client when they click on my email link. To do this, I'm going to use the mail-to hyperlink. This section wasn't included in my mockup, but I wanted to include an image of me in my workspace in my portfolio. I created a div with the class ImageDivider. The image will be added via CSS in part 2 of this tutorial. Alright, so we've reached the last section of code in this tutorial. We're going to code up the footer of my website. It's super easy to do, so let's begin. First, we're going to use the footer tag. Within the footer tag, we're going to create a div and give it the class footer content. Then, we're going to use the paragraph tag and give it the class credit and write some copyright text. Then, we're going to use the unordered list tag and give it a class called social. Within the unordered list tag, we're going to use the list tag and then the anchor tag and link to all of our social media. By using target blank, when the link is clicked, it will open the link in a new tab, as opposed to opening the link by leaving the current page. Well, that's it. That's all the HTML that was coded to make this one-page portfolio website a reality. If you're having trouble with your HTML code, watch my video and read my blog post, The 10 Most Common HTML Coding Mistakes. It will help you a ton. Stay tuned for next week's video, part 2, where we'll be coding up all the CSS for this one-page portfolio website. As always, thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in part 2.